International Women's Day. International Women's Day, IWOT, is celebrated on the 8th of March every year. It is a focal point in the movement for women's rights. After the Socialist Party of America organized a Women's Day on the 28th of February, 1909 in New York, the 1910 International Socialist Women's Conference suggested a Women's Day be held annually. After women gained suffrage in Soviet Russia in 1917, the 8th of March became a national holiday there. The day was then predominantly celebrated by the socialist movement in communist countries until it was adopted in 1975 by the United Nations. Today, International Women's Day is a public holiday in some countries and largely ignored elsewhere. In some places, it is a day of protest, in others, it is a day that celebrates womanhood. History. The earliest Women's Day observance, called National Women's Day, was held on the 28th of February, 1909 in New York, organized by the Socialist Party of America at the suggestion of Teresa Mulkey L., though there have been claims that the day was commemorating a protest by women garment workers in New York on the 8th of March, 1857. Researchers have described this as a myth. In August 1910, an International Socialist Women's Conference was organized to precede the general meeting of the Socialist Second International in Copenhagen, Denmark, inspired in part by the American Socialists. German socialist Louise Zietz proposed the establishment of an annual Women's Day and was seconded by fellow socialist and later communist leader Clara Zetkin, supported by Kurt Dunker, although no date was specified at that conference. Delegates, 100 women from 17 countries, agreed with the idea as a strategy to promote equal rights including suffrage for women. The following year on the 19th of March, 1911, IWOT was marked for the first time by over a million people in Austria, Denmark, Germany and Switzerland. In the Austro-Hungarian Empire alone, there were 300 demonstrations. In Vienna, women paraded on the Ringstrasse and carried banners honoring the martyrs of the Paris Commune. Women demanded that they be given the right to vote and to hold public office. They also protested against employment sex discrimination. The Americans continued to celebrate National Women's Day on the last Sunday in February. In 1913, Russian women observed their first International Women's Day on the last Saturday in February, by the Julian calendar then used in Russia. In 1914, International Women's Day was held on the 8th of March in Germany, possibly because that day was a Sunday, and now it is always held on the 8th of March in all countries. The 1914 observance of the day in Germany was dedicated to women's right to vote, which German women did not win until 1918. In London there was a march from Bow to Trafalgar Square in support of women's suffrage on the 8th of March, 1914. Sylvia Pankhurst was arrested in front of Charing Cross Station on her way to speak in Trafalgar Square. On the 8th of March, 1917, on the Gregorian calendar, in the capital of the Russian Empire, Petrograd, women textile workers began a demonstration, covering the whole city. This marked the beginning of the February Revolution, which alongside the October Revolution made up the Russian Revolution. Women in St. Petersburg went on strike that day for bread and peace, demanding the end of World War I, an end to Russian food shortages, and the end of Tsarism. Leon Trotsky wrote, "The 23rd of February, the 8th of March, was International Women's Day and meetings and actions were foreseen, but we did not imagine that this Women's Day would inaugurate the revolution. Revolutionary actions were foreseen but without date. But in the morning, despite the orders to the contrary, textile workers left their work in several factories and sent delegates to ask for support of the strike, which led to mass strike. All went out into the streets." 7 days later, the Emperor of Russia, Nicholas II, abdicated and the provisional government granted women the right to vote. Following the October Revolution, the Bolshevik Alexandra Kollontai and Vladimir Lenin made it an official holiday in the Soviet Union, but it was a working day until 1965. On the 8th of May, 1965, by the decree of the USSR Presidium of the Supreme Soviet, International Women's Day was declared a non-working day in the USSR in commemoration of the outstanding merits of Soviet women in communistic construction, in the defense of their fatherland during the Great Patriotic War, in their heroism and selflessness at the front and in the rear, and also marking the great contribution of women to strengthening friendship between peoples, and the struggle for peace. But still, Women's Day must be celebrated as are other holidays. From its official adoption in Soviet Russia following the revolution in 1917, the holiday was predominantly celebrated in communist countries and by the communist movement worldwide. It was celebrated by the communists in China from 1922. After the founding of the People's Republic of China on the 1st of October, 1949, the State Council proclaimed on the 23rd of December that the 8th of March would be made an official holiday with women in China given a half day off. Communist leader Dolores Ibarra led a women's march in Madrid in 1936 on the eve of the Spanish Civil War. The United Nations began celebrating International Women's Day in the International Women's Year, 1975. In 1977, the United Nations General Assembly invited member states to proclaim the 8th of March as the UN Day for Women's Rights and World Peace. In 2010, on the occasion of 2010 International Women's Day, the International Committee of the Red Cross, ICRC, drew attention to the hardships displaced women endure. The displacement of populations is one of the gravest consequences of today's armed conflicts. It affects women in a host of ways. In 2011, though the celebration in the West was low-key, events took place in more than 100 countries on the 8th of March, 2011 to commemorate the 100th anniversary of International Women's Day. In the United States, President Barack Obama proclaimed March 2011 to be Women's History Month, calling Americans to mark it by reflecting on the extraordinary accomplishments of women in shaping the country's history. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton launched the 100 Women Initiative, empowering women and girls through international exchanges, on the eve of IWOT. In the run-up to 2011 International Women's Day, the Red Cross called on states and other entities not to relent in their efforts to prevent rape and other forms of sexual violence that harm the lives and dignity of countless women in conflict zones around the world every year. Australia issued an IWOT 100th anniversary commemorative 20-cent coin. In Egypt, however, the day was a step back for women. In Egypt's Tahrir Square, hundreds of men came out not in support, but to harass the women who came out to stand up for their rights as the police and military stood by watching the events unfold in front of them, doing nothing to stop the crowds of men. The women, some in headscarves and flowing robes, others in jeans, had marched to Cairo's central Tahrir Square to celebrate International Women's Day, but crowds of men soon outnumbered them and chased them out, wrote Hadil Al-Shalchi for the Associated Press, AP. In 2012, the UN theme for International Women's Day 2012 was Empower Rural Women, End Hunger and Poverty. In that year, Oxfam America invited people to celebrate inspiring women in their lives by sending a free International Women's Day card or honoring a woman whose efforts had made a difference in the fight against hunger and poverty with Oxfam's International Women's Day Award. On the occasion of International Women's Day 2012, the ICRC called for more action to help the mothers and wives of people who have gone missing during armed conflict. The vast majority of people who go missing in connection with conflict are men, as well as the anguish of not knowing what has happened to the missing husband or son. Many of these women face economic and practical difficulties. The ICRC underlined the duty of parties to a conflict to search for the missing and provide information to the families. In 2013, the UN theme for International Women's Day 2013 was A Promise is a Promise, Time for Action to End Violence Against Women. While International Women's Day 2013 declared the year's theme of the gender agenda, gaining momentum, the 2013 International Women's Day, the International Committee of the Red Cross, ICRC, draw attention to the plight of women in prison. In 2014, the UN theme for International Women's Day 2014 was Equality for Women is Progress for All. American singer Beyoncé also posted an International Women's Day video to her YouTube account. Throughout the video, her song Flawless plays, which includes a portion of the We Should All Be Feminists speech given by author Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie. In 2015, the UN theme for International Women's Day 2015 was Empowering Women, Empowering Humanity, Picture It. Governments and activists around the world will commemorate the 20th anniversary year of the Beijing Declaration and Platform for Action, an historic roadmap that sets the agenda for realizing women's rights. In 2016, the International Women's Day theme for 2016 was Planet 50-50 by 2030, Step It Up for Gender Equality. The President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, in his message issued on the eve of International Women's Day said, "On the occasion of International Women's Day, I extend warm greetings and good wishes to the women of India and thank them for their contributions over the years in the building of our nation." The Ministry of Women and Child Development announced the setting up of 4-1 stop crisis centres on the 8th of March, in addition to the 8 already functioning across the country. Ahead of Women's Day, the national carrier Air India operated what it claimed to be the world's longest non-stop flight, where the entire flight operations were handled by women, as part of International Women's Day celebrations. The flight, from Delhi to San Francisco, covered a distance of around 14,500 kilometers in around 17 hours. In 2017, the theme for International Women's Day 2017 was Women in the Changing World of Work, Planet 50-50 by 2030. In a message in support of International Women's Day, the UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres commented on how women's rights were being reduced, restricted and reversed. With men still in leadership positions and a widening economic gender gap, he called for change by empowering women at all levels, enabling their voices to be heard and giving them control over their own lives and over the future of our world. IWA 2018, the theme for International Women's Day 2018 was Time Is Now, Rural and Urban Activists Transforming Women's Lives. Around the world, the day is an official holiday in Afghanistan, Angola, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Belarus, Burkina Faso, Cambodia, China, for women only, Cuba, Georgia, Guinea-Bissau, Eritrea, Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Laos, Madagascar, for women only, Moldova, Mongolia, Nepal, Russia, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, Uganda, Ukraine, Uzbekistan, Vietnam, and Zambia. In some countries, such as Cameroon, Croatia, Romania, Bosnia and Herzegovina, Bulgaria and Chile, the day is not a public holiday, but is widely observed nonetheless. On this day it is customary for men to give the women in their lives, friends, mothers, wives, girlfriends, daughters, colleagues, etc., flowers and small gifts. In some countries, such as Bulgaria and Romania, it is also observed as an equivalent of Mother's Day, where children also give small presents to their mothers and grandmothers. In Russia, the day has lost all political context through the time, becoming simply a day to honor women and feminine beauty. In the Czechoslovak Socialist Republic, huge Soviet-style celebrations were held annually. After the fall of communism, the holiday, generally considered to be one of the major symbols of the old regime, fell into obscurity. International Women's Day was re-established as an official important day by the Parliament of the Czech Republic in 2004 on the proposal of the Social Democrats and Communists. This has provoked some controversy as a large part of the public as well as the political right see the holiday as a relic of the nation's communist past. International Women's Day sparked violence in Tehran, Iran on the 4th of March, 2007, when police beat hundreds of men and women who were planning a rally. A previous rally for the occasion was held in Tehran in 2003. Police arrested dozens of women and some were released after several days of solitary confinement and interrogation. Shadi Sadr, Mabuba Baskilizadeh and several more community activists were released on the 19th of March, 2007, ending a 15-day hunger strike. In Italy, to celebrate the day, men give yellow mimosas to women. Communist politician Teresa Mattei chose the mimosa in 1946 as the symbol of IWA in Italy because she felt that the French symbols of the day, violet and lily of the valley, were too scarce and expensive to be used effectively in Italy. In the United States, actress and human rights activist Beata Pozniak worked with the mayor of Los Angeles and the governor of California to lobby members of the U.S. Congress to propose official recognition of the holiday. In February 1994, H.J. Res. 316 was introduced by Rep. Maxine Waters, along with 79 co-sponsors, in an attempt to officially recognize the 8th of March of that year as International Women's Day. The bill was subsequently referred to and remained in the House Committee on Post Office and Civil Service. No vote of either House of Congress was achieved on this piece of legislation. As of 2019, International Women's Day will also be celebrated as a public holiday in the federal state of Berlin, Germany. Official UN themes. Year UN theme 1996, Celebrating the Past, Planning for the Future 1997, Women and the Peace Table 1998, Women and Human Rights 1999, World Free of Violence Against Women 2000, Women Uniting for Peace 2001, Women and Peace, Women Managing Conflicts 2002, Afghan Women Today, Realities and Opportunities 2003, Gender Equality and the Millennium Development Goals 2004, Women and Heavy Age 2005, Gender Equality Beyond 2005, Building a More Secure Future 2006, Women and Decision Making 2007, Ending Impunity for Violence Against Women and Girls 2008, Investing in Women and Girls 2009, Women and Men United to End Violence Against Women and Girls 2010, Equal Rights, Equal Opportunities, Progress for All 2011, Equal Access to Education, Training, and Science and Technology, Pathway to Decent Work for Women 2012, Empower Rural Women, End Poverty and Hunger 2013, A Promise is a Promise, Time for Action to End Violence Against Women 2014, Equality for Women is Progress for All 2015, Empowering Women, Empowering Humanity, Picture a 2016 Planet 50-50 by 2030, Step It Up for Gender Equality 2017, Women in the Changing World of Work, Planet 50-50 by 2030-2018, Time Is Now, Rural and Urban Activists Transforming Women's Lives 2019, Think Equal, Build Smart, Innovate for Change. subscribe Wiki Audio YouTube page below, click notification or bell icon to get future videos uploaded as instant notification, and write your valuable comment, suggestion, feedback to improve in future videos. Check out channel page to get more videos and share this channel to your friends and relatives.